scheduled service to replace low battery voltage on your Model X like this car does, well, I'm going to show you how to fix it. How does that sound? First thing you're going to want to do, open up your frunk. So you're going to go to your controls, front trunk, open up the front trunk. Next thing you're going to do is you're going to go into safety. You're going to power off the car. Power off, leave the doors open, leave the windows open, and head on up to the frunk. I'll see you there in a second. All right, now we're up at the frunk. Let's open that baby up. And so from this point, now we're going to remove this plastic that goes around here. So we'll start with the top one. Now the left side. All right, so now we're going to take off this rubber piece. I recommend leaving it in this exact orientation inside of here, just like that. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to pull this back and disconnect your two lights.
So these are the two lights that you're going to disconnect. Now you may be thinking, his audio just changed. And that's because I wanted to speed up most of this process. So it goes in two times for pretty much the rest of the video. But what you're going to do is disconnect those lights, and then you're going to make sure there's not a bunch of crap in the frunk. And you're going to pull the carpet out of there. You'll be able to pull everything out all in one kit, but set it off to the side. And the next thing you're going to want to do is you're going to focus on these 10 millimeter bolts. You don't need to focus on these bolts because those are the bolts that hold the HEPA filter in place. And if you're not messing with the HEPA filter, then there's no reason to replace them. It saves you a little bit of time. It's not the end of the world if you take them off. It'll just leave you with a HEPA filter dangling back there. But there is a way to just leave it in place. And then when you pull out the whole plastic frunk, you're just going to basically pull it forward towards you and clear the AC duct that it goes to. You'll see that here in a second. So there's the AC duct square. The next thing you're going to do is take off these two 10 millimeter bolts that hold this battery bracket in place. Then the next thing you're going to do after that is you're going to remove this battery vent off the side. And then you're going to remove this tube that takes away the rainwater from the windshield. Then you're going to loosen up the battery. Oh yeah, don't forget to disconnect your fireman's loop there. After you get your battery disconnected, that's the negative lead. Then disconnect the positive lead. Set that off to the side. And the next thing you're going to do is you're going to want to focus on the two 13 millimeter bolts that sit on the top of the battery bracket tray. So I'm reaching in with my 13 millimeter wrench and I'm loosening those. And then I'm going to hand thread them out. They're pretty long bolts, so it takes a minute. Just hang tight. All right, got one out. Now I'm going to go for the other one. Man, that was fast. All right, so now the next thing you're going to do is you're going to loosen up that bottom bracket and pull it out just like that. Now the whole thing's out and set it in a nice secure place. This spot works good. Now you're going to remove this 10 millimeter nut that sits on top of this battery hold down. Pull the battery out and put the new battery in. So this battery actually, it looked like at some point that's the negative and the positive leads there. So negative will be on the left if you have it sitting like me, and positive on the right. So you're going to tighten up that 10 millimeter nut. But what I was going to say was this, not this battery, but it looked like a battery before that had leaked acid out and it was all rusty. So now we're going to go ahead and wiggle that battery and bracket all back into place. And so what you're trying to do is clear that bar on the bottom. And what I found to turn it sideways just a little bit helps it get it into place there. So once you got it into place, you're going to put the 10 millimeter bolts back in on the bottom. And then you're going to get your 13 millimeter bolts, put those in on the top. So a total of four bolts hold this in place. So there's the other one. And again, don't get frustrated. Getting this battery in there is kind of difficult. It's 20 pounds probably sitting way out in front of you. And so it's not the easiest thing to do, but you'll get it. It goes in there. All right, so I tighten those up with the wrench, and now I'm going to tighten up the 10 millimeters on the bottom here with my impact. All right, so now the next thing I'm going to focus on is getting all the wiring put back into place, putting the positive lead on, putting the negative lead on, now tightening up the negative lead, tightening up the positive lead, The next thing I'm going to do is push this tube back into place. And this is held on with a little like clip. So I use my set of clip pliers, open it up, and then just push it straight up onto the window trough there. So next thing I'm going to do is grab the frunk, slide it into place. You're going to put the front end first and then kind of maneuver that HEPA filter air intake onto the back there. Now you want to make sure your wires are sticking out the front here, which I'm doing right now. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and tap it, make sure it's all secure into place, make sure all your holes are going to line up. And then from this point, you're going to put all your bolts back in. So all your 10 millimeter bolts, go ahead and start putting all those back into place. And when you're doing this, obviously don't make sure you don't cross thread them. So if you put one in and it starts to meet too much resistance, stop, take it out, do it again. It's always recommended you hand thread these first, but I'm an experienced professional, so I just send them straight with the impact. So now you're going to put your carpet back in, hook up your lights. So once your carpet's in, you're going to work on putting that rubber molding back in. And so you're just putting this in, working it all the way around. You want to make sure the carpet is underneath of there and it grabs onto the plastic of the frunk. It takes a minute. Just got to maneuver it around, kind of pull it up to trim there. That's it. Next thing you're going to do is put on your frunk plastic pieces. So you do the front one first, then you're going to do the side one. Make sure you close your washer fluid reservoir if you open it up. Then you do your left one. And then last one is your top one. So once that's all in place, you're all good. Now we head to the inside of the car where we gotta turn it on. Now I first press on the brake and this will sometimes boot it up, but instead I had to do the soft steering wheel resets, hold the both scroll wheels at the same time till your instrument cluster comes on. And then once that comes on, you wait for it to say you need to calibrate your doors and then your MCU turns on.
So as we sit here and wait for the car to boot up, basically, all we have to do now is pull it outside, run a calibration for the doors, make sure the doors calibrate completely fine, and then after that, give it back to the customer. If you're doing it by yourself, go ahead and crack yourself open a nice cold brewski and tell yourself, congratulations, you've changed out your own 12-volt battery. So the time on the clock here is 1:12. When I first started this, I think it was 12:45. So this is after me doing it a couple times, but also me setting up the cameras and doing all that. I'm gonna title this as how to change your Model X battery out in under 30 minutes, because I think it can be done. If I didn't have to set up the camera, I could have been done in under 30 minutes. And after watching this video and doing a little research, having your tools ready, so your 10 millimeter, 13 millimeter open end wrench, that's all you need. Now, as you can see, it says right here, calibration needed. Hold button to close door until calibration is complete. Please make sure there is sufficient clearance for door to open and close during this calibration process. So we're going to pull it out, run it through the calibration process. That's it. Thanks for watching. Now have yourself a nice cold brewski. You've successfully changed out your 12-volt battery on your Model X.